one man 40 teaspoons of sugar a day.
But they must be hidden sugars found in commonly perceived healthy foods and drinks.
It's called that sugar film. And here's that sugar guy answering one key question.
Are you crazy?
I'm breezy. I was so aware that there were such mixed messages about nutrition, but sugar in particular. I kind of thought, well, the only way to actually find out is if I do an experiment myself.
So Damon set out to consume the same amount of sugar as the average Australian, 40 teaspoons a day.
40 a day?
Yeah, 40 a day.
Yeah, the average Australian consumes up to 40 teaspoons of sugar a day. Behold, the average Australian eating an average Australian breakfast. That's nearly 20 teaspoons of sugar, and it's not even 9 a.m.
Okie dokie. So we're going to do some chocolate brownies. There's a surprise ingredient though.
Okay.
We can't freak out.
Okay.
Sweet potato.
Sweet potato in chocolate brownies.
Yeah.
What you're seeing here makes no sense.
I feel like you're making a savoury quiche or something.
But on some level, this lady knows what she's doing.
Here's something I prepared earlier.
So that has sweet potato in it?
Totally.
That's really good.
Yeah.
A few years back, Natalie quit refined sugar.
I just was relying on it too much throughout my day.
She still eats sweet stuff though.
We've got these, and I usually don't tell people what's in them.
Take a guess. Is it A, chocolate, B, I don't know, mousse stuff, C, more chocolate, or D, none of the above? Okay, one more. Is it E, avocado? It's E. Well done. The colour is cacao, but the sugar is almost non-existent, yet it's quite sweet.
Yum.
I should do food stories more often.
So she started the 50-day no sugar challenge.
I was really shocked. I thought, oh, you know, 10 or so people would want to do it, but it kind of happened that thousands and thousands were joining.
Going sugar-free might be so hot right now, but there's no denying the increasing science that shows how bad excess sugar is for our health.
The research is showing that sugary drinks in particular contribute to overweight and obesity and are a risk factor for diabetes. And we know that a lot of highly processed foods, which are high in sugar, are also bad for our health, and we're eating a lot of them and we need to eat less. This is a 600ml bottle with 16 teaspoons of sugar.
You know what? Let's bring up the recommended daily intake.
6 to 8. How much does that Coke have again?
16, that's a lot. I don't mean to sound like your mum, but don't drink this sh-.
We've known for some time that soft drinks aren't great, but we're still learning about the real impact sugar's having on our bodies. Here are just a few ailments that have been linked to excess sugar. Heart disease, certain cancers, liver damage, memory loss. But the real danger is not even knowing that we're consuming it. For example, how much tomato sauce ends up on your fries? Like this much? There's a teaspoon of sugar in that tablespoon of sauce.
How does it even fit in there? There's so much sugar jammed into random foods that we wouldn't even know it. You know what? Let's play a little game. One for the road.
We walked as far as the makeup room to do journalism with the most famous people at SBS.
Except for Lily and Shin, she didn't want to do it.
Which one has more sugar in them?
Couscous salad or chocolate croissant?
4 cans of Heinz baked beans, or is it this entire block?
Exact same brand, exact same marketing, one's wholemeal, one's white.
Yogurt?
Right.
Or is it this picnic?
Croissant. Energy drink.
White bread.
Ba-bow. V8. Ba-bow.
It was a trick question, right?
Are you sure?
I would say that one.
Ba-bow.
My strike rate is like 1 out of 4 so far.
Correct, it's the baked beans.
So in short, if you want to eat less sugar, you're better off eating these than you are eating these so-called healthy foods.
Advertising and marketing play a huge role in creating demand for these sorts of products, particularly the junk foods. And we know that a lot of what's marketed, particularly to children, is unhealthy foods.
Like the ads during the most popular kids show on TV, My Kitchen Rules.
My Fanta tastes like an awesome ride.
My Fanta tastes like diabetes.
These ads are so harmful that the UN has kind of termed them a form of child abuse. And yet there's little restriction on what ads play when, or more pressingly, where. Because in Adland's unfettered playground, you can find all sorts, including seemingly real information, like this from Kellogg's.
Sugar in ready-to-eat cereals is actually a small percentage of daily sugar intake.
Yeah, that's because we're eating 40 teaspoons of sugar a day. If we were eating the recommended 6 to 8, a bowl of cereal would make up all of it. Sheesh.
It's hard to cut through the bullshit when there's just so much out there. That's why Jane, among others, is calling for two key things: taxes on high sugar products and labels that cut the crap. Sound familiar?
To give you the cigarette that treats you better in every way.
So back to that sugar guy. In case you're wondering, he's still alive.
So now I've done that sugar film, I think I actually need to show some respect to my body and to my family and probably not do that again, because I do have some residual. There's a little bit of... just a little bit of man fat that I can't quite get rid of, just above the belt line. So I think that'll be a permanent reminder of my time in the sugar film. Every time I'm in the mirror, thank you.